I'm Aubrey Cornelius, and we are here for another installment of Drop the Mic with the lovely Amanda Faison from 5280 Magazine. We are at High Point Creamery in Hilltop, which is like my favorite ice cream shop in the city.
It's fantastic. We're here often. In fact, I've already been here this week.
That's great. And we chose this location because you and I share a lot of likes. Mm-hmm. And a lot of loves in our life, but I think ice cream is like at the top of that list.
Tippy top, absolutely.
Yeah. What are you eating over there?
So I have the rosemary apricot and then the Earl Grey shortbread, which I almost always order that one. And I just kind of bolstered it with a second flavor this time.
Bolstered. I like it. Just give a little. I also got the Earl Grey with shortbread and I did the mint with chocolate bark. You have been at 5280 Magazine. You've been there a long time. What has kept you there for so long? And what do you love about being food editor?
I mean, the magazine itself, it just continues to grow. I mean, I started when it was teensy tiny. And not only has the magazine grown, but the city's grown. And we've grown with it. And I've been able to grow with the magazine. So there's so much happening in this city. And that's the great thing about working for a magazine like 5280 or any city magazine is you're covering lifestyle. So you're covering all the happenings of a city, not just one single beat, although I do mostly cover food. And food in this town right now is just blowing up.
What is the next kale?
I think it's the grain bowl or the the macro bowl or whatever people are calling it. Mm-hmm. And it is kind of kale-y because you can put kale in there. It's also healthy. but I think the cool thing about the bowl is that it's infinitely just customizable. You can do anything with it. You can have it at breakfast, you can have it at lunch, you can have it at dinner, you can put an egg on it, you can do anything with it. And you're seeing it more and more all over, and fast casual all the way to maybe not fine dining, but you know, finer dining. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So I think that I also think fried chicken is having its moment. So total opposite.
Tell us about your book club.
It's called Food Lovers Book Club, and it's always a cookbook or some sort of food lit book. So it's a topic, a book, and then an expert comes in. It's super fun. But anyway, the premise of it was, I just feel like food brings people together, whether it's ice cream or, you know, spices or whatever it is, people love talking about it. And why not create a forum where people can come together, talk recipes, talk food issues, and, you know, have a free event, have a book so that people are actually cooking more or maybe they're reading more.
What would you say your spirit emoji is?
I really love the little pow sign, you know, the little spark or I always kind of look at it as like poof or pow or I don't know. I love that one. One I would love to use more often because I always look at it, but then there's like no reason to use it is the hazelnut. And it's so random, but every once in a while I try and work that into like some text or something like that.
What are your vices?
Ice cream would definitely be one. It used to be just kind of like sugar in general, but I've kind of moved away from, not even for health reasons, just, I don't know, I'm just don't crave sugar as much as I used to, unless it's pie or something baked like that. And then salty snacks during happy hour. Definitely something like chips or I don't know, something like that. But really at that hour, like the 5:30 kind of hour. I don't know, sort of weird.
That's it. Yeah.
All right.
We can eat.
Okay. Sounds good.